What's up, you guys? This is Matt with Hoopsology, and we just saw an incredible performance in a game seven by the Golden State Warriors. Congratulations to them. So we want to take a look right now at a little preview of Golden State versus their opponents, the Los Angeles Lakers. This will be the sixth seed versus the seven seed in the second round, or the conference semifinals, as some call it. And this will start on May 2nd at 10 p.m. Eastern Time on TNT. Looking at this series, I think there is a lot of arguments for both teams. I think you could see a case where if the Lakers can get to the basket a lot, they can get easy buckets. And I think they have potential to get more easy buckets than the Golden State Warriors do, which would be certainly a feather in the Lakers' cap. When we look at advantages in different aspects of the game, home court advantage goes to Golden State, and they do have a great home court advantage. So having more games there, I think, is going to be a factor. And at some point, you'd have to figure the Lakers being a seven seed is going to be a detriment to them. Defensively, both teams pretty versatile. I think the Lakers have better interior defense. I think the Warriors have a little bit more versatility with what they can do, and Draymond had some impressive showings against the Kings there. Rebounding wise, I think with what you saw from Kevon Looney, solid rebounder. Yes, may not do a whole lot on the offensive side for them, but if he can just get some offensive rebounds, that's going to be a huge advantage for the Golden State Warriors, obviously giving them more shot attempts and potentially more three-point attempts as well, more points, etc. You get the idea. So I think Golden State does have a slight advantage in rebounding. Really, no player on the Lakers like Kevon Looney. Offensively, I think the Lakers actually are the better overall offensive team for everything except for the perimeter. And I think in the modern age of basketball, as you all well know, having an advantage at the perimeter is a huge trump card and can cause tons of variability in the series. So you could see where the Lakers potentially get to the basket a lot. Maybe Anthony Davis is able to take advantage of some matchups, but the pace is just slower for the Lakers, and so maybe they struggle to keep up with the Warriors. So offensively, I would give a slight advantage to the Lakers, but it's a huge deal, as we've seen the past several years, having Curry and Klay Thompson. Durability and depth wise, I think it's about even. We know that LeBron has been playing on that injury, that foot injury, since before the playoffs started. So you wonder if that's going to creep up. We know that there are tons of jokes every series about AD potentially going out. Hopefully he can stay healthy, of course. Durability wise, for Golden State too, it's a similar situation where if any of their key players, Draymond, Curry, or Klay, are injured, then that's going to be a big deal for them and a big loss that's going to be hard to imagine them recovering from. I think it's about even. Because if LeBron or AD goes out for the Lakers, you'd imagine it's pretty much over for them.
Same thing.
And I think bench wise, I mean, both teams have players that are a factor. I would give Golden State the slight edge if I had to choose between the two for durability and depth. Looking at their first round matchups, I think the Lakers won convincingly, but against a Memphis Grizzlies team that was clearly young, a little bit distracted potentially with all the antics, a little bit disoriented and weakened by injuries that they had coming into it. They really could have used Steven Adams. And also the Warriors put to rest a young team as well in the Sacramento Kings, who I think did a great job, but the Warriors just kind of showed that championship poise that they have in the third quarter of that game seven. I mean, it was just incredible what the Warriors were able to do on the road in a game seven. Kevon Looney being a beast on the boards, and of course, Steph Curry with that 50-point performance, just really putting the offense on his back. I do think the first round matchup, the Golden State gets credit for beating a more quality opponent there. And so based on what we've seen and all those things discussed, looking at predicting this series, I do give Golden State the advantage here. I know that that's not really a hot take because they were your champions from last year. But man, it feels weird to pick the Warriors winning in a second round matchup given the chaotic season that they've had. But in fairness, who would have thought the Lakers would be here at this point in time as well? So I'm going to go with Golden State in six games. But let me know what you think. Where am I right? Where am I wrong? How do you see this series playing out? Either way, really looking forward to watching this play out. Take care. We'll talk to you soon. Peace out.